Hi folks, this is Moondan Raghavan. Today the topic is TensorFlow introduction, requirements and installations. So this video will all about just a installation and introduction about the TensorFlow and other required details. So let's dive into the topic. So today agenda, introduction to the TensorFlow, and we will see what is TensorFlow and how it will be useful for machine learning. And next one is PyCharm as IDE. So any language you take, just you will have an IDE. It will help you to code faster and very effectively. And next one, the language which we choose for machine learning here is Python. And Python virtual environment concept. So it is a very main important concept in Python in case of machine learning as well. And we will see CPU, GPU and TPU difference. Because till now we might have seen the CPU platform, or you might have seen the iOS or Android, but here we have other units, let's say GPU and TPU as well. So it is a very vital to know what are those things, and because we will be using those things in our machine learning. So introduction to TensorFlow. So since it's a very introduction video, we will just talk about very, very high level about the TensorFlow. But in the next videos, we will see total what are the APIs available in this TensorFlow and how we can use for machine learning. So since the definition goes like TensorFlow is an open source machine learning library. So it's a library basically and used for model building. So by this time, we will be knowing what is model and what are the features and other those things. So it's very useful to build the model here and robust ML production and research as well. So building model, it may be easy, but again, it should be working well in the production and should handle every kind of data. So in that case, you need to build a very robust model. So for those things, it will be very useful and for researching purpose as well. And it is a graph-based computational framework. So which means that it will generate your model as a graph and you need to just execute as a graph. And in general, tensor means multi-dimensional array. So it goes little mathematical concepts. So multi-dimensional array. So you might have seen a single dimensional or two dimensional or three dimensional, but it will look for multi-dimensional. In case of multi-dimensional, it's little difficult to visualize the multi-dimensional array. But however, we can handle a multi-dimensional array in the TensorFlow. So as you know that there are so many features for a given input. So those things, I mean, inputs can have more features. So it will just reflect in a multidimensional array. And flow represents a graph of operations. So it will go through the different operations. And TensorFlow has internally categories, has high level APIs and low level APIs. So we will see these APIs in coming session. But it's just to aware that it will have the different APIs. Based on our requirement, we will see the different types of APIs. And example, scalar. So it goes a little scientific. So scalar only magnitude, a tensor rank of zero. It's like index, it starts from zero. And vector, you know, it's a magnitude and direction. So scalar, you can consider just like a weight. So a person's weight will not have any direction. It will have only the magnitude, but in case of speed. So in case of speed, you will have only the speed, but in case of direction plus speed. So it's a different case. It's a vector. So that time you will tell acceleration. So those kind of things will be having a rank of one because it has two entities. One is magnitude, another one is direction. Then the overall definition or let's say API information will be available in the official site of TensorFlow. It is www.tensorflow.org. However, all the references being mentioned in this video will be mentioned in the comment section. So going to the next slide, it's a PyCharm as IDE. So in case of if you take Python as your language, so it is one of the best IDE for the Python. Of course, we are going to use PyCharm Community Edition, which is free for open source. And it is some of the features are like intelligent Python editor, graphical debugger. So as you start working on the PyCharm, you will be just understanding this concept rather than explaining as a theoretical here. And the reference for PyCharm as IDE is www.jetbrains.com/PyCharm. So just we'll go to the before one. So TensorFlow we have seen and PyCharm we have seen. Because why I'm going through this list of items are like we need to install these applications or the IDEs in coming session, so it will be useful. And in case of if you want to practice anything in the machine learning, it is very necessary. So Python as a programming language. So for learning machine language, it's very required to learn one language. Either it may be R language or Python language, or even TensorFlow will be supported by the JavaScript as. So Python as programming language. So Python is a popular programming language. It was created in 1991 before Java. And generally it will be used for web development, software development, mathematics concepts, system scripting. It is very useful for so many areas, but especially it is useful for machine learning as well. And just to install the Python, or let's say through Python, we need to install the TensorFlow. It is PIP install TensorFlow. So for installing any packages or libraries, we will use the command PIP install TensorFlow. If you're aware of that, it will be easy. But in case if you don't know Python till now, this point, so better to learn Python for 1 or 2 weeks. So if you're already a developer, so it's very easy to learn a Python language in within a 1 week. Or if you are entirely new to the Python programming language, then maximum it will take 3 weeks of time. So however, I have mentioned the reference for the Python. So it's a Python org. Next one, Python virtual environment concept. So it's again a subtopic in the Python. However, we will just touch up on the topic. So it's just like you will have different versions of code base or different versions of libraries. If you want to check that different versions of library, it's little sometimes it's difficult to just install the different versions for testing or just to verify the functionalities. So in that case, you will just isolate the environment for checking particular version, so which is nothing but our virtual environment. So general definition, like a cooperatively isolated runtime environment that allows Python users and applications to install and upgrade Python distribution packages without interfering with the behavior of other Python applications running on the same system. So in general, you will have a different kind of library installed in your system. It will be working for all the code base. It will be working for all the applications. Let's say you want to have application, it has to work with the different versions of same library. Then in that case, you will go for the virtual environment. And the reference I have mentioned, and already I have created the video on the Python virtual environment tutorial. So I have mentioned the link here as well, and I will mention the same in the comment session. The next one, CPU, GPU, and TPU. So this will be useful in the long run, or it may be useful in after some time, but it's better to know now only. So CPU, we all know that CPU is a central processing unit used for small models or data sets. But GPU, you might have seen whoever just interested in gamings, so they will be using the GPU because it's mainly using for images and video processing. And obviously it will be useful for large models to medium data sets. And TPU, Tensor Processing Unit, it's developed by Google, and it's mainly for matrix computations and dense vector processing. So it's little heavy to learn now only on TPU, but it's necessary to know if there is a TPU and it was developed by the Google. So in coming sessions, we will just, when we do the practicals, we may come to know about the TPU. Also, TensorFlow runs on Android, iOS, Raspberry Pi. So the man who does not read has no advantage over the man who cannot read. So said by Mark Twain. So it means that the man who does not read, so he has the capability to read, but he never read. And the one more guy is there, he cannot read because he never learned to read. So if we both are equal, that means that we need to read if we already know how to read. So better read more books and learn for your future. And whatever we saw till now, it's about the PyCharm. So just install the PyCharm. And next one is Python. So install the Python. And next, install the TensorFlow. So if you install these things, so it will be useful for the coming sessions. So thanks all. Thanks for watching.